Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day.
Jhulan Yatra organizers ki jai. Jhulan Yatra participants ki jai. Hare Krishna. Thank you. Anyway, it was a fantastic festival. Prabhupada said, you can see if the festival is nicely performed or the worship is going on, you can see how Krishna is pleased. You can tell that the whole worship is going nicely. So Radha Madhava there every night, and they were very blissful, I thought. They were smiling at everyone. So the way it's growing now, like, is what do you say? Bhavananda Prabhu has got a very good eye for art and things like that. And he said, I guess India is the only place in the world where you can go in an empty field, nothing there, and create a palace and fountains and lights and trees. He was very impressed with the whole thing, as most people were. And also the I was informed that the on YouTube or over 4 lakhs of people.
Yeah, the first day we had 400,000 views on Facebook.
400,000 people tuned in to Radha Govinda's Jhulan Yatra. That's incredible. Murari Gupta Prabhu, he had a nice realization, and he was saying that this whole era, this computer age and communication, and it's so fast now. He said it seems like it's being orchestrated by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and his mission. So he started his mission, which has to spread all over the world, but even Prabhupada's godbrothers were saying, well, how could this can be done? Because they were also before the computer ages, the godbrothers also. But they were saying, how is it possible, how it was spread all over the world so quickly? But you can see here, already 400,000 people are just tuning in to see, so how to spread Krishna consciousness and preach Krishna consciousness. Now we just see the fingertips, and immediately thousands and thousands and millions of people are going to hear and see and everything. So, yeah, I thought that was a nice realization of Murari Gupta Prabhu. This is the purpose of the whole invention of communication. So, the Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's message can be spread in every town or village very, very quickly, beyond our imagination. Anyway, it was beautiful. Set up, lights. I have one thing I was a little bit. This is a bit of a room for improvement here, but I was a little bit in anxiety when the deities were standing on that table. At the end, we were throwing flowers and offering them meru deep, and I thought maybe that I was a little bit scared that that table was a little bit wobbly. The legs, it wasn't wobbly, but I'm always in anxiety when Radha Madhava leave the temple. My consciousness is always there if I'm doing something else. And but anyway, perhaps that could be fixed. Put some extra bamboo supports on the legs and things like that. Otherwise, it just gets better and better every year. Congratulations to all the organizers and the participants and whatever little bit you did, Shadam distribution and Chapan Bog, that they cook for the Radha Madhava every evening. Yeah. And also it's going to develop more. We have land now set aside in that we can beautify it, because the management one theme park here, like Vrindavan, and they're offering different departments if they want to build different theme parks. So the deity department has volunteered to build and maintain one, and they suggested you take the Vrindavan theme, so we're going to make a theme park in Vrindavan. And of course Radha Madhava's Jhulan is a part of that. It's the Nitya Leela, they're doing it anyway, so that'll be there, so they can have a they'll be raising the land, and then we can just, however, to our heart's content, we can develop a Vrindavan theme park, and of course the Jhulan will be there. So it's just expanding and expanding. It's a very wonderful thing that the ISKCON youth have taken. Otherwise we would actually have still been in the Radha Madhava's temple with the Jhulan. You saw yesterday was the Jhulan, was in the morning. So that was a regular, that was the Jhulan, that little area there, so we can see how much expanded since the youth wanted to exhibit their talents and bhakti by glorifying, now we have a huge setup up there, and it's all, Krishna conscious stuff. It's all, I know the organizers, obviously, because I've to organize something like this, it takes a lot of people. It's a total involvement in consciousness. Their consciousness has to be totally involved to get all these things done, all the management and the etc. like that. So that's fantastic. That's Krishna consciousness. We want to be totally absorbed in Krishna consciousness and know what kind of activity or service it's doing, but it's demanding our consciousness, full attention, for months before the festival and during the festival. So this is Krishna consciousness in the spiritual realm, Goloka. That same consciousness is there. how to maintain and then expand the pastimes of Radha Govinda. So it takes total absorption in consciousness. So here just a few dedicated devotees have created this wonderful thing, but you can see how it's expanding more and more. It's like the YouTube, was it? WhatsApp?
Facebook.
Database.
Facebook.
Oh, Facebook, okay.
YouTube.
Okay, I'm not familiar with the language. But, you can see how more and more people, once they've seen it, they're going to see it again every year, and then they're going to want to start participating, So it's just going to expand like anything. And this is Krishna consciousness movement. Somehow or another, we want everybody to be absorbed in Krishna, then the whole consciousness should be totally absorbed. And this, we see that the managers and all the devotees here, they get that privilege of actually being totally absorbed. You have to be. I mean, I was one pujari at one time, so it just takes total absorption and no time for anything else. Yeah. So this is everybody is benefiting. It's a win-win. The people who organize get a complete total absorption in one way, and then the devotees who are just coming to enjoy, enjoying bliss and totally absorbed in the festivities. So this is Krishna consciousness. We want to be totally absorbed 24 hours a day. And we see how it works when we don't have time for Maya, because there's so many things to do for. So this is the positive aspect of Krishna consciousness. We don't have to worry about the negative side, because all of our consciousness is in the positive side of Krishna consciousness. This is the way to conquer negativity is be positive. So completely absorbed in making this grand festival for Radha Govinda, Radha Madhava. We see how it's expanding the whole consciousness. So we're in Lord Chaitanya's land now. They must have been there at the Jhulan. Prabhupada said they used to be in London Temple. Did you see Lord Brahma was there at the Artik and Lord Shiva? Did you see that? The devotees said, no, we didn't see. Oh, yeah, they're coming to see the Sandhi Artik. Narad Muni coming there. This is all our parampara. So what to speak of Mayapur Dham? This is eternal. I'm sure they'll come to the Jhulan for the for the Sandhi Artik at least. Yeah, usually they have it at the joke pit, but I think they're leaving at the joke pit and coming to participate in Radha Madhava's Jhulan here. Well, they could do both anyway. Anyway, I'd like to thank all the organizers for taking over, making everything nice, everything going smoothly. Gauranga satisfied means Prabhupada satisfied means the Parampara satisfied. Means we also become satisfied. So thank you all, organizers and participators. Sri Prabhupada ki jai. Hare Krishna.
Like our ad-free videos? Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day, and don't forget to like and share our channel.